Good morning, students. In the previous classes of English, you have learned about the different poems, lessons, and the stories. But today we will move to the English grammar. In the second standard, you have learned grammar. In the grammar, you have studied many things like vowels, vowels with the different sounds, describing words, action words, naming words, genders, etc. Today, let us learn something more about that and the different matters. Today's our topic is sentences, words, and letters. Lesson number one, sentences, words, and letters. My dear students, please listen here. These sentences are made up of words, and words are made up of the letters. Now let us see through the examples. I will take one word. For example, India. Here, this word India, in this we can see five letters. All the letters are independent. I, N, D, I, A. These all the letters are independent, but when they join together, it will become India, a word, a meaningful word, India. Like this, through the letters, words will be formed. This is about the words. The same way, different words we can frame. And through these words, we can frame the sentences. Then what is a sentence? Sentence is a group of words which gives the complete sense. We can join some words and frame the sentences. But that should be give the meanings, complete meanings. For example, we can join some letters. You, I, can, she. These are the group of words, but there is no meaning. So we will not call it as a sentences. When we will call this as a sentence, it should give the meanings. For example, I am going to the school. This is one sentence. This is a group of words and gives the correct meaning. I am going to the school. Like this, many sentences we can frame. And in the sentences also, there are many differences. For example, some sentences are with the only one word. Which are they? Hall. Hall. Here only one sentence, only one word is there, but it is called as a sentence. Hall. And some sentences are having two words. Come here. Come here. Here only two words are there. But this is called as a sentence. Come here. This is a one sentence. And most of the sentences are having more than 3, 4, or 5 words. We are all Indians. This is the 4-word sentence. But all these are called as a sentence. I hope all of you understood about this letters, words, and sentences. When we go to the exercises, we will learn better than this. Let us see the exercises. In your grammar book, children, page number 6. Sorry, page number 4. Here are some exercises. Let us see that. Worksheet 1. In that A main, you see, make a word from each set of letters. Here some letters are given. From that we have to frame some meaningful words. First one is B O O G. From this we can frame a meaningful word. Good. G O O D. This is a one word which is having a meaning. Good. Second one is S S L C A. From these 5 letters we can frame the word class. 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 Next one you see. L O O S H C. This is school. S C H O O L. Like this, some other letters are there. From that we have to frame different words. Fourth one is A D I N I. From these letters we can frame the word I N D I A, India, the name of our country. Fifth one, H A C M T. From this we can frame the word M A T C H, match. Sixth one, R A M G M A R. From this we can frame the word grammar. What we are learning now, grammar. I think all of you are understanding this, what I am telling. From the different letters we can frame the different words. And now let us move to the next main, framing the sentences. Framing the sentences. Students, here are some pictures and some sentences are already given. We have to match the sentences with these pictures. First picture you see, here two boys are playing. And which sentence is suiting for this? That we have to write below the picture. For the first picture, the sentence is children play football in the evening. Children play football in the evening. Next picture is horse. Here is one horse. And which sentence is suiting for that? The horse is a useful animal. The third picture you see, the bear is a wild animal. The fourth picture, birds build their nest in the trees. The fifth picture you see, here is one rose. The rose smells sweet. Fifth picture, the dog is a faithful animal. These are the different pictures and suitable sentences. The sentences are already given in the book, so I did not write it. Please see the textbook and you have to write. It is in the page number 4. Next we will see the C main. We will frame the sentences with the filling some words. Put words into the blank and make sentences. Make sentences. Students, here are some sentences, but these sentences are not complete sentences. They are incomplete. Why? There some words are missing. If we put the suitable words in the sentences, these sentences will be incomplete. These sentences will be complete. Let us see that C main. First one, C. Dash came here to see his uncle. We have to complete this sentence by writing the first word. Any names we can write, but here we have to observe word his. So we have to write any boy's name. For example, I will write Kiran. Kiran came to see his uncle. Now the sentence is complete. After the sentence, there must be full stop. Kiran came to see his uncle. Like this, second sentence you see, Dash went back to his village. Here also word his is there, so we have to write boy's name. For example, Charan. Charan went back to his village. Charan went back to his village. Now the sentence is complete. Third one you see. She told a dash. Which word we can use here? Any words. She told a story or song. Fourth one. Rama and Dash are good friends. Here we have to use one word. For example, Shama. Rama and Shama are good friends. Next one. Dash is your name. Here, which word we have to use? We have to use the word what. What is your name? If you ask, this is a question. But then only the sentence will be complete. Next one, here you see. Dash built their nest in trees. Here we have to use only the word birds. Birds build their nest in trees. Now let us move to the D main. D main. Write sentences. Write sentences about these pictures. My dear students, here are some pictures, but they have asked us to write one suitable sentence about these pictures. First picture you can see, Taj Mahal. We can write many sentences about Taj Mahal. But only one sentence I will tell you. Taj Mahal is in Agra. Taj Mahal is in Agra. Or you can write, Taj Mahal is built by Shah Jahan. Like this we can write many sentences. The second picture you see, one camel is there. We have to write the sentence. Camel is called sheep of the desert. Third sentence. Postman brings letters for us. Fourth one, you can see one cow there. Cow gives us milk. Fifth one, one picture of the apple is there. An apple is red in color. Last one, we can see the picture of one lion. we can write one sentence about the lion. The lion roars loudly. Isn't it, children? Yes, like this we can frame different sentences. Now you understood that from the letters we can frame some meaningful words, and from the different words we can frame different meaningful sentences. I hope all of you understood this. Now let us move to the next lesson, that is capital and small letters. Lesson number 2, capital and small letters. Dear students, you have learned already that English alphabet has 26 letters. But these letters can be write in two forms, capital letters and small letters. The capital letters like A, B, C, D, and small letters like A, B, C, D, and these capital letters have some significance. We have to use these capital letters in some of the particular places. Today let us learn about that, where we have to use the capital letters. Now I will explain you about this. Capital letters are used in the first letter of the first word in every sentences. That is compulsory to use the capital letters. For example, she went to market. Here the first letter is she. Here S must be compulsory capital letters. And one more thing you have to remember, after the full stop we will continue the sentence. Then also we have to write the first letter capital. She will go to temple also. Once again, after the full stop, once again the sentence starts. Then also we have to see that the first letter must be capital letter. And next is, we have to write the word ball. In this, the first letter must be always capital. G, O, B, ball. We cannot write G, O, B in the small letter. God, G should be always capital letter. And in the first letter of a particular name of a different person's place, we will call it as a nouns. We have to write capital letters. It may be first, middle or the last. We have to always write it in the capital letter. For example, the Taj Mahal is in Agra. The Taj Mahal is in Agra. Here Taj Mahal is noun, so we have to write first letter capital, and Agra is noun, name of the place, so we have to write A capital letter. Like this, any nouns which will come in first or last or between, we have to write capital letters. And the first letter of the name of the day and month. In the week we have 7 days and we have 12 months. All these words must be written in the capital letters. For example, Sunday मंडे और जनवरी फेब्रुवरी ऑल दिस लेटर्स मस्ट बी कैपिटल लेटर इट मे बी इन द फर्स्ट और लास्ट इन द सेंटेंसेस एनी वेर इट मे राइट इट मस्ट बी इन द कैपिटल लेटर्स एंड द फर्स्ट लेटर ऑफ द फर्स्ट वर्ड ऑफ ईच लाइन ऑफ द पोयम यू हैव लर्न मेनी पोयम्स एंड इन दिस पोयम सम 8 और 10 और 12 लाइन्स मे कम ईच वर्ड ऑफ द लाइन फर्स्ट लेटर मस्ट बी कैपिटल लेटर्स For example, you have learned the poem. Sports is fun for each and everyone. Let's go out. Like this. Each letter of the first word must be In the poem, first letter of the each words must be capital letters. The same way, another word, some particular words, I and O, it may come in any place in a independent as a independent words. There we must write capital letters. For example. I will go to home. Oh my God. Here, this I and O are independent letters. So, we should write always I and O in a capital letters. I think all of you are understanding what I am telling. So let us move to the worksheets. Rewrite each sentences using capital letters where needed. The first sentence is given here. My cousin is living in Australia these days. Here we have to use the capital letters. But where we have to use my, the first letter of this sentence. Yum, my cousin is living in Australia. The name of the country Australia. So we must write it in the capital letter. First letter A must be capital letters. These days. See here. My cousin lives in Australia. These days. M must be capital and A must be capital. So, this is the correct sentence. My cousin lives in Australia these days. Second sentence you see. Kalpana flew to Mumbai last Sunday at 8 a.m. Here, which are the words must be right in the capital letters you see. Kalpana, the name of the girl. And not only that, it is a first word of the sentence. So you must write K capital letter. Kalpana flew to Mumbai. Mumbai is the name of the place. So you must write M capital letter. Last Sunday. In the Sunday we must write S capital letter because it is a name of the day. At 8 a.m. Kalpana flew home. Mumbai last Sunday at 8 a.m. Now the sentence is correct. Kalpana A must be capital. Here in Mumbai M must be capital and Sunday must be capital. Like this, some other sentences are there. We all are Indians and so we are brothers and sisters. Here we must write first letter W in the capital letter. We all are Indians. I must be always capital. And so we are brothers and sisters. Like this we will see the other sentences. Here B and C main are given. Children, you should do it as a homework. Write the names of the days of the week and write the names of the months of the year. All of you know the names of the days and the months, so you must write it as a homework. The same way, write the names of any three mountains. You can write the mountain's name, but I will tell you some mountain's name. Mount Everest, Mount K2 or Mount Annapurna, these are the mountain's name and you must remember to write the first letter of the mountains also in capital letters. I hope all of you understood to use the capital letters in the different places. Children, whatever I taught you now, we will give you in the PDF and you can write it in the grammar book. I hope all of you understood this grammar. Thank you. Have a nice day.